Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining me. I found a video that was posted on Elgato website. I translated this Twitter post. It says, while some institutions claim that the area had already been burned by lava, images updated by a drone show otherwise. They have here on this Twitter post this area, this pool marked in yellow. In that pool, there is a dog trapped and still alive. I took some screen captures. This area right here is the little dog or big dog. It's hard to tell. It's probably a big dog. And it's been running back and forth along this wall trying to get out. Here are a few of the screen captures that I recorded. There's one of them. There's the little dog. You can see its shadow. And we got another one. You can actually see it's got a long, fluffy tail. And I marked it in red. And then here it is when it was trying to get out of the pool over here in this corner. Heartbreaking. I am hoping with this news coverage that someone will go there and rescue that dog. This is the exclusion zone that the only people probably allowed to go in this area are scientists, and they have been finding animals and rescuing them. There was another Twitter post where this morning some of the evacuated people were being allowed to return to their homes for a short period of time to collect their belongings. And evidently the military has been dispatched there to help with the cleanup of ash. This was according to Margarita Robles, who visited the island today. IGN, yesterday I believe it was, showed images of volcanologists there on the island rescuing some chickens. Rubian Lopez says they were collecting these chickens that were abandoned there in La Palma. Yeah, the dog, yeah, someone needs to get in there and rescue him. Being Sunday, let's all pray for this pet and the other pets that someone can come and rescue them all. Another post, it says that 1,186 buildings have been damaged or destroyed. Some of them have collapsed. You know, it only takes about 4 inches of ash for the roofs of buildings to fall down. They're also saying that the new lava flow from the collapse of the cone on Saturday night has destroyed the last of the few remaining buildings in Togonique. The flow of the lava reached 1,240 degrees. And this paper, which might be a little bit more updated, says 1,281 buildings have been affected or destroyed by the lava. 38.3 kilometers of roads have been destroyed. So that would be about 28, almost 29 miles of roads. As for the lava delta, that's the lava that's going out into the ocean. It continues to expand in the north and south direction, feeding from various points and reaching an area of 32 hectares. So that would be 79 acres of lava out there in the ocean. Airspace for the area is restricted to any type of aircraft below 3,000 feet, except for security forces and bodies of emergency services. Here we have some images from the 8th of some of the earthquakes that occurred there. Here it is for the entire day for the 8th. This here is from the 9th, yesterday. And this is what its current activity is showing. IGN has 91 earthquakes listed so far just today. We got a 4.0. Yeah, deep, 38 kilometers in depth. Here you can see the date. Let's come down here. I had noticed on ESMC, I'll show you that in a minute, there's been a lot of earthquakes along the rift system. At least that's where they're reporting them. Okay, and that was yesterday. Yeah. All right, so here's the 4.0. And then we'll go to the map of the location. That's as big as I can make it. This is the rift, this center line right here. The most recent that ESMC has a 3.4 deep, 35 kilometers in depth. And I've talked about how the magma is coming up from the mantle of the earth. Very deep. This volcano is nowhere close to being settling down or finished. And there's the location. I'll make it big again. There's the rift. Very concerning. The airport is open, but I do not believe that any flights are actually leaving. They say, well, come on down to the airport. But that doesn't mean that your plane's gonna take off. Here's another image from rtvc.es of the lava that is currently flowing because of the latest eruption. Now, when the latest eruption happened, the collapse of the cone, this here is an image, is just an example. It was throwing out blocks of lava that were as big as three-story buildings. This here is an image of some of the lava flows that were filmed last night. This image is from CNN. The water, or not the water, but it looked like water. The lava was flowing so fast, it looked like rapids. The water in a rapids. That's how fast that lava was flowing when the collapse occurred. I was watching it, and I could have swore I saw lightning occurring, which I haven't seen before during the eruptions of La Cumbre de Yehe. Sorry for pronouncing it wrong. I'm dyslexic, and I have a hard time pronouncing a lot of words, and sometimes I read my sentences backwards. But anyways, yeah, I thought I had seen lightning. And according to CNN, yeah, there was lightning during that collapse and the subsequent pyroclastic flow. Here is a screen capture of that lava during that, or after the eruption, and some of the buildings that were destroyed. So heartbreaking for these people. But heartbreaking too for the animals that they depend on us. They need to get out and save those animals. Another screen capture of one of the buildings being destroyed. This was at 3:25 a.m. their time on October 9th. Here's an image of that lava flowing. This is an example of what I was saying. It was running so fast it looked like rapids in a stream. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch and share my videos. Please stay safe. Always be prepared for a disaster. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.